side passing. If you've never done this with your horse before, don't start with the most complicated obstacle. We start easy. Like, so for Jill today, we're going to give her, we're going to review the basic fundamentals that go into moving a horse laterally. I've got to be able to move my horse truly sideways, and then I've also got to be able to negotiate a turn on forehand and a turn on haunch. So the obstacle that you had at the show had a really sharp angle, and that's difficult. It was like a lightning bolt, and that was hard. I also need to have a horse that understands when I'm asking them to move and when they should stop. And that was a problem that I think everybody was having, was their horses wouldn't stop and they were drifting through. So I'm just gonna go ahead. I want my horse to learn to protect the obstacle, to not want to bump into it, okay? Also, I need to understand the relation of where is the horse's head and how much bend can I have. If I'm pulling my horse's head to try to stop her, part of her body is going to swing away, which would be the hindquarters. So if you had problems where your horse was drifting through a pole and your horse had their head pulled towards you, you had too much bend in the head and neck, and the hindquarters got out of alignment with the obstacle. So I would start by taking it slow. And you see I've positioned her ready to side pass right over the pole. I'm gonna get her attention, and I'm gonna start asking for little increments. She needs to wake up here. Looking at sharp. So I'll get her shoulder moving and then her hip moving. Shoulder, hip. Shoulder, hip, shoulder, hip. I'm gonna let her have a little break. We just got to this little angle. She hasn't touched anything yet. Now you could use your whip or not, but everybody notice I'm working her in hand. I'm standing in a place where I can control how much bend I have in her head and neck. When I want her moving away from me, if it's the shoulder, I want her head slightly away. If it's the hip, I want it slightly towards. Shoulder, hip, shoulder, hip. And I pushed her back there because she was going to come up into the pole. So I've got quite a bit going on here to protect what I'm doing. Okay, I want to make sure I come clean. Now I'm going to ask her to back around this cone. Steady pressure on the halter, and I'm guiding her hindquarters by placement of my focus, my whip, and little taps on the rein. Okay? So that's something that you're going to practice today, is being able to back your horse in a circle around a cone. And I kept trying to keep her equal distance. I'm going to have her stop. I'm going to change sides. Now I'm going to side pass left. Hindquarters need to catch up, and I need to keep her from creeping forward. A little more shoulder, a little more hindquarters. Good. You'll notice as she goes along here, I need a little more forehand, or a little more forequarters to yield, and then the hindquarters. So the entire time, I want to keep control over. There, I needed to ask her not to come forward. I want her to step completely clean away, and then I'm gonna carefully walk her away from the obstacle. Okay, so I want to start slow and steady. If I get a horse that gets reactive and drifty, I've got ways I can show you to work on that. I want the horse to wait for me to ask them to move. I don't want her just to see it and assume that we're going, because her assumption could be wrong. I know from going to trail competitions, they might want me to stop halfway and change directions. If the horse gets on an auto cruise and starts drifting, I'm not gonna be able to do that. So relaxation is the key. If the horse feels pressured because the obstacle is below them, they have a hard time relaxing. So we're gonna train it To train this, we have to first train our horses to understand the fundamentals of how to yield laterally. So that's what we're going to do when I put her away. We're going to review fundamentals of training the horse to move laterally, and then incorporating the obstacle means first we got to make sure they're not afraid of it. And then they can put, this puts their dressage to practical principle. You'll notice as I was able to get her yielding sideways, she started to cross correctly, yeah, crossing the outside front leg over the inside front leg, and the same in the hind, which is a detail that I want to establish in yielding my horse sideways, whether it's a leg yield or a side pass or a half pass. I want to get those legs crossing correctly so that it's balanced, but not with, in a trail obstacle, not ever with sacrificing ticking a pole. I want to train the horse to be responsible for where their feet are. They can't be responsible for where their feet are if I'm not also concerned about it. Okay? So that's the end of our demo. We'll get on with the rest.